Cautious as you travel this day. We just come thanking the Lord for His mercies this morning, for His goodness. As you can hear, I'm in the car. So we thank God for traveling mercy. The Lord, earlier this week, I was driving like I'm always doing. No surprise. I was listening to Waze, so I use Waze to drive. You know, it warns you about the police, it warns you about potholes, it warns you about pretty much everything. As long as, you know, other drivers on the road report it, it warns you about any possible thing. Roadkill on the road ahead, you know, that one was new for me, but it tells you pretty much everything. And you know, the cue, the sign that the lady or the man gives you is hazard reported ahead, right? For the majority of things, it's hazard reported ahead, unless it's specific, you know, fog reported ahead, construction on road ahead, whatever it is, right? But the majority of things is hazard reported ahead. And, you know, I also take the train because, my job and my church are not in a 30-minute proximity or even a 30-mile proximity from where I live. So, you know, it takes a while to get to everywhere. And, you know, the other day on the Metro North, I was sleeping. And, you know, it's like I saw, you know how you have those quick dreams? You sleep for a really short period of time. And you have a quick dream, and it's like, has, like, you know, I saw the orange cone. I saw the orange cones, and I was like, oh, that reminds me of when the lady in Waze says, has it reported ahead. And for me, I got to thinking, and I was like, you know, God is really a good God. He's really a God that will warn you and will try to, you know, if it's in His intention, He will warn you of things to come. He will warn you of downfalls to come. He will warn you of any sort of pitfalls or anything, right? Now, let's take Joseph in the Bible and Pharaoh. Joseph was, he was a servant to one of the guards in the prison, right? And Pharaoh had this dream, or he had two dreams, rather. One, that of cows. He was standing by the Nile, and there were seven cows that came up that were full and fat and plenty. And then right behind those cows, another seven came up that were dark and skinny and gaunt, and you know, they ate the full fat cows, and then it didn't even look like they ate them. And then he had another dream where seven bushels of grain, you know, appeared and was growing, and they were healthy. And then he also had seven grains that were withered and thin and scorched by, you know, like the heat and the wind, right? So Joseph, as he was in the jail, two men that Pharaoh called on, these magicians and the sorcerers, he called on them to interpret his dream initially, and they couldn't interpret it, and they said, you know, that they failed him, like, you know, they see that they're not, that their skill is not up to par. So they get thrown into the jail cell because they weren't able to interpret the dream. They meet Joseph, the young man, and they themselves have dreams, and the young man interprets them, which is Joseph, and they come to pass. exactly how he says. So they now send for, Pharaoh finds out about it, Pharaoh now sends for Joseph to come and to interpret his dreams. So as Pharaoh's explaining to Joseph what is happening in these dreams, you know, Joseph says, it's not me that will interpret, but God will give you the interpretation through me, right? So God then reveals to Joseph that it would be 7 years of famine. I mean, 7 years of plenty and then 7 years of famine, right? So what happened was, it was 7 years of great abundance coming through the land of Egypt, but 7 years of famine will follow them, right? Then all the abundance in Egypt will be forgotten, and the famine will ravage the land. The abundance in the land will not be remembered because the famine that follows it will be so severe. The reason the dream was given to Pharaoh in two forms is that the matter has been firmly decided by God, and God will do it soon, right? Now, God basically put out a warning. This is going to happen no matter what. But I'm warning you, you're going to have 7 years of abundance, and then you're going to have 7 years of famine that are going to be so severe you're not going to be able to come back from it. Right? Now, Joseph, being who he is and who he was called to be, with discernment, with prayer, with wisdom, you know, was able to instruct Pharaoh on how to prepare and how to plan. I feel like preparation and prepare and plan is like the word for the year for me. I don't know. Keep talking about it. But Joseph was able to tell Pharaoh how to prepare and how to plan and how to set aside things for the famine, right? So if you're going to have 7 years where, let's take your example, you get a job and, like, you're making six figures and you're living your best life, you can pay off all your debt, you can pay down everything, you can pay off your car,